we're not talking about as much is how more meaningful work can become and how much more opportunity and new and different roles technology is going to present to us to be able to really have really fulfilling careers. Both employee and management know less about the future than ever before. One industry in particular, let's take the travel industry. Because of the internet, everyone can now book their travel tickets on their own. So many travel agents, unfortunately, lost their jobs, but at the same time, maybe 10 times as many new jobs were created by sites like TripAdvisor or Expedia. But the challenges and the friction is most of the new jobs created in the travel industry were not taken by the people who lost their jobs. And I think we need to change the conversation and we need to change the marketing of technology to show people, hey, there's a lot of new upside here for you. And what you have now more is an experience-based economy where people are thinking less around how long they're going to be somewhere and more around what kind of meaningful work they're going to do. I think one of the challenges with the gig economy is the infrastructure of support is really driven by people having a job in a company. However, what I find fascinating as the father of several children is how kids today are seeing the opportunities to make money through a YouTube or something like an Airbnb or an eBay. What my kids see is that they can go to YouTube and creating content that's valuable makes them valuable. So that's a great lesson for kids. If you look at companies like an Airbnb or like a YouTube, what's their product? They don't have a product. Their product is the platform. The product is us. We are the product, and we're able to leverage that platform to make money. And that's a new way of creating value. They're creating a way for people to create on their own. And I think that's a beautiful thing. And the good news is most people are seeing outside of organizations many, many ways that they can be more entrepreneurial. And so these bigger organizations, I think, are going to benefit from the psychology shift for people to be able to create more value and to be able to do that in ways that are without a lot of friction. So I get asked a lot in interviews, whether it's on television or radio or print, Steve, tell us, what are the most important skills that people need today in the digital economy and for tomorrow? And my answer is usually pretty simple. I could tell you what I think they are today, but I can also tell you with a high degree of certainty that in 2 years, there will be different skills. You should think more around, can I learn new things? Can I apply them quickly? Because if you can, you're going to be infinitely more valuable than people that have a hard time learning new things. The biggest reason employees leave companies today is because I don't think they feel they're growing fast enough. And you don't want to be somewhere where you're not learning and growing, because you know whatever industry you're in, it's going to be changing. I think the promise needs to be, we're going to help make you vital for an uncertain future. Come here and we'll teach you new skills, new technologies, new methodologies that you can't learn anywhere else. I think one of the most fascinating trends in the world of work right now is absolutely the fact that employees have more power and their voice carries more weight than at any time in history. There are numerous sites out there where employees can go and voice their concerns. And I think companies are still learning to adjust to this new reality. When you see the, you know, leading technology companies of the world, like an Amazon or Google or even a Facebook, get brought to their knees because of their employee voice questioning decisions or questioning their transparency, it makes you realize that, you know, the internet was really only built about 25 years ago. We're just at the very early phases of learning what that really means for us in terms of how we relate, but it is fundamentally changing the relationship between management and workers, and it's putting pressure in the right places. Employees have access to more information to know if you're not being honest. And that's actually a very healthy element of friction that's been introduced in the working relationship. I think more than ever before, in an uncertain world, if you want to hire the best people and you want to keep the best people, you really need to build that on a foundation of trust. And I think that comes down to lots more communication, a lot more listening, a lot more asking of questions. I think we're getting too seduced by technology that whenever we talk about what's next as leaders, we talk about technical elements. We don't talk about the richness and the greatness that is going to happen for people who are working and how the future is going to be brighter. We're digitally transforming because you're going to be able to do more exciting work, and you're going to be able to do more interesting things, and you're not going to have to do the crap work. Technology can replace that. You're going to get to do the good, thoughtful, interesting, innovative, you know, human-centered work. I think we need to do a much better job marketing the human upside of how technology can realize greater benefits. We need to demystify it. We need to put humanity in front a little bit more than the technology, which is, I believe, why we're using the technology to have a greater, greater experience in life.